Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's take another look at how you uninstall apps in Mac OS X. So to figure out how to uninstall an app on your Mac, you need to know how it was installed in the first place. And if you can't remember, it's okay because you can usually figure it out. Because the first thing you want to do when you want to uninstall an app is just try to do it the simplest way using Launchpad. So run Launchpad and it's going to show all of your apps and you can swipe through them or click the dots to go through each page and find the app that you want to uninstall. Now what you want to do is you want to click and hold that app. Now it really doesn't matter which app you click and hold. You can click and hold any of them. But what you're going to do after a few seconds is everything's going to wiggle like this and you're going to see some little X buttons appear on some of the apps but not others. Now the ones it appears on are apps that you've installed through the Mac App Store. So the Mac App Store itself has the information it needs to be able to uninstall the app. And all you need to do to uninstall those apps is click the little X button and Launchpad will take care of the rest. That's all you need to do. And if you've only ever installed apps from the Mac App Store, that's all you need to do to uninstall any app on your Mac. Now for most other apps, the main way you uninstall them is so incredibly easy that a lot of Mac users get tripped up by this. They think it must be more complex. But all you really need to do in 90% of the cases is go to the Applications folder where you can see all of your applications and find that app that you want to delete and simply drag it to the trash. And that's it. And it seems like it should be more complex than that. It seems like there should be some sort of uninstaller app or something like that. Some big process to get it uninstalled. But in fact, that's not the case. However, if you want to be sure that's the right thing to do, there are a few things that you can do. First, take a look at what you've got inside of your Applications folder. Sometimes there actually is an uninstaller involved. Like for instance, in my scanning software here, if I look in there, there's a folder that contains a bunch of different components. And in there, I find a uninstaller. So there are some apps that actually have uninstallers and they're pretty easy to find. There weren't that many files there and I was able to look and find this one quickly. And it makes sense because the scanning software actually creates extensions that are used throughout the OS. So it makes sense that there would be some sort of more complex method for uninstalling this because it's not a cut and dry simple app. Sometimes you'll actually find an installer, like the installer that you use to actually install the software in the first place. This is rarely done now, but sometimes those installers actually have two modes, install and uninstall. And that's why the installer sticks around after you've even installed the software. But that's kind of rare. In most cases, it's simply going to be drag and drop. Now, if that doesn't satisfy you and you want to make absolutely sure that you're doing everything right, then what you probably want to do is actually go to the developer's website and search for the support section and see what they say for uninstalling. Most developers will have something in their support section about uninstalling. So here, for instance, on the site for Firefox, there's a whole page dedicated to uninstalling Firefox from your computer. Now in this case, it's a very reassuring page because it tells you to uninstall Firefox. All you need to do is do exactly what I said, is drag the Firefox application to the trash and you're done. I did a quick survey around of a lot of different developers and a lot of them have pages that are just like this that say that's all you need to do and to assure you that dragging the application to the trash is all you need. However, in some cases they'll give you some more steps. So checking with the developer could be a good idea, especially if you suspect that an application does a little bit more than just control documents, that it actually does things with your system and there might be more things you need to uninstall. Now I want to show you another example. Suppose you have an old copy of Microsoft Office on your Mac. If you search, you can find at the Microsoft site instructions for removing that. And it does start off with basically dragging the application to the trash, but then it has more detailed information about removing preferences and other things. So it's very easily spelled out here and you can follow it easily. Now I do want to warn you, when you search for something using Google and you say uninstall in the name of the app and Mac, you will come up with a lot of sites that are not the official support sites for those apps. And a lot of times they are just sites trying to sell you uninstalling software that you don't need. So make sure you go to the developer's site, not just search Google in general, because you might be misled there. Now, there is another way you can uninstall software if the software you have is cloud-based software, like for instance Adobe Cloud. If you have Adobe Creative Cloud, you'll have the little app here and you can see the apps you've got installed, such as Photoshop, and you can uninstall directly from the Creative Cloud app. So this is going to become more and more common as companies like Adobe create their apps as cloud services. And the great thing about this, of course, is that you can uninstall these apps and also install them from here. So I rarely use, say, Adobe Illustrator. So if I wanted to clear off space on my hard drive, I can uninstall it now. And then later on, I can go and install it as I can the other apps here. So if all else fails, if you have tried uninstalling using Launchpad, if you have tried dragging and dropping from the Applications folder and found out that wasn't sufficient, if you searched online for the company's website and looked to find uninstall instructions there and that hasn't worked, then I would go to the discussions.apple.com website and search for uninstall and the name of the app and see what comes up. See what other people have dealt with. I would not use an uninstaller app because it may not work either. Also, you're installing something to uninstall something else, which I don't like if you're trying to clean things off. And in almost all cases, you don't need it because anything an uninstaller app does, you can do yourself. You just need to find out how. So information is your friend and should get you to be able to uninstall any app. If you've installed something that's malicious or semi-malicious, like some app that is not going to want to uninstall itself, then I recommend going to the Genius Bar and asking for help to get the problem solved. Because at that point you're not really dealing with uninstalling software, you're dealing with fixing an actual problem on your Mac. I would seek professional help for that.